This is Hyfindr Expo Highlights today with Oliver Franz from Burckhardt Compression. Oliver, welcome.
Hi, Stephen. Thank you for having me.
You are presenting at the show today. What innovations are you presenting?
Yeah, our focus is on very large capacity hydrogen compressors, okay. Mostly oil-free designs for the hydrogen for mobility and energy market.
Right, okay. So how do these look?
Yeah, so two of the technology we present here is our fully packaged standardized solutions for hydrogen trailer filling as well as hydrogen refueling systems. So these systems are standardized and designed to deliver sufficient amount of hydrogen attached to like a 2.5 megawatt electrolyzer. We package these and scale them up to 10 or even 20 megawatt in a packaged modularized solution.
Mm-hmm. So this is just to compress the hydrogen that's coming out of the electrolyzer.
Absolutely, yes.
Okay. So what would come after this? Storage, or what would usually come after that?
Exactly. So we would have, like, on the suction side, we would typically receive something like 30 bar hydrogen.
Yes.
And compress the amount up to 550 bar for a 350 bar filling process, for example. So the filling equipment, the trailer filling or the car filling equipment would be subsequent to our containerized units.
All right. Okay. And so is this unique? So this is a standardized unit which you basically can scale?
Absolutely. So this is a standardized unit we build in volumes now,
yes,
for the global market. We started off in Europe with European packages, as well as are fostering the same business here in North America right now towards the American standards in volume, repeat, very cost competitive and very short lead times, very high capacity units.
Okay, so this is the innovation that you're showing.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And how is it integrated, or is there more that you can show us about this?
So this solution typically becomes part of a larger package,
yes,
with hydrogen refueling companies,
yes,
that deliver filling equipment, that probably have the electrolyzer, have the feed gas system,
yes,
attached to this. So this becomes an integral part, probably the most critical part of any refueling station. So longevity, runtime, meantime between overhaul, a very solid compressor, that's the core of this solution.
Okay, perfect. Oliver, so do you have other innovations that you are presenting?
Yeah, the other innovation we have presented here at the show is our capacities around hydrogen liquefaction. Uh-huh. So you see that is one of the larger compressors of our product lines. We built these compressors up to maximum 40,000 horsepower on a single compressor frame. Now these probably would be in the 10,000 horsepower range to deliver the compression power required for hydrogen liquefaction processes. We're having a lot of projects right now active for hydrogen liquefaction in North America, but some in Europe and Asia as well.
Okay. Can you tell us briefly how this liquefaction thing works?
Yeah, good question. Yeah. So I have a slide on that. So
okay, yeah.
we have a hydrogen feed gas process. So the hydrogen,
yeah,
feed gas comes on the bottom side,
okay,
comes in relatively warm atmospheric and comes out at 20 Kelvin, really cold.
Oh, yes.
So to get it to that cold temperature, it requires some massive compressor power here. The high pressure and the low pressure compressors utilizing some clog process here between hydrogen being run in circles, energy being removed, and sudden expansion at the very end through a Joule-Thomson valve, which leads to a two-phase process between liquid hydrogen here, and then it will be re-vaporized to finally cool down the feed gas stream to get down to 20 Kelvin over multiple steps. Heat exchangers involves a lot of close collaboration between ourselves and the licensor here. We deliver the compressor into a larger unit here that requires a very efficient and very reliable compressor solutions, very,
okay,
large ones.
Oliver, just for the understanding, so the hydrogen is literally just flowing through here, and these are heat exchangers through which it flows.
Absolutely.
Yeah? And you are basically, with your compressor, not compressing the hydrogen, but you're compressing a coolant liquid or whatever else to get to those temperatures. Right?
Exactly. The refrigerant that we pump in the round here,
yeah,
is actually also hydrogen.
Also hydrogen. Oh, really?
But exactly as it did say, so this is literally like a really big fridge. The cold,
yeah,
box is a giant fridge.
Yeah,
it's,
yeah,
coming down to like 20 Kelvin absolute.
Okay.
And our compressors deliver the cooling.
And your compressor, so is cooling all, basically, it's delivering this compressed fluid to here. And then does this get colder as you go along, or
absolutely,
is it always,
yes,
the same?
Getting colder and colder and colder,
colder, okay,
to finally deliver a temperature of like minus 252 Celsius.
All right.
At which hydrogen will liquefy, and it's fed typically at 30 bar feed gas pressure, so there may be a compressor here as well.
As well, okay.
Yeah.
Cool. And that big machine we saw on the other side, what kind of volumes can it handle then of that liquefied
So the schematic we saw before probably is like a 15 ton per day, 13 ton per day. But the same compressor could also handle the gas of a, say, 100 megawatt, 200 megawatt electrolyzer feed gas to be handled away.
Okay, 200 megawatt electrolyzer. I like that. Yeah. can you, on that note, can you give us a bit of an outlook on where this is going? Where are you seeing everything developing in this area?
Yeah, we see a really strong trend towards ever larger compressors, ever higher pressure. You saw on the filling side, we have the smaller but also a larger units. We see need to really push the limit towards 550, 700, 900 bar at very high capacity scale, not only for storage, but also for pipeline injection, feed gas compressor, but for the heavy duty and trailer filling, we see a need for ever larger compressors, and we are the ones ready for the scale up. We're not so good at the very, very small compressors, but we're good at very big machines, scaling up, and really breaking boundaries into new, stronger, higher pressure, heavy duty solutions.
Wow, okay, that looks like a very promising future. Also, the hydrogen economy growing. Thank you very much, Oliver, for coming by. And
thank
I
you,
wish
Steven.
You a good time at the show and even thereafter. Thank you.
Thank you, Steven.
Thanks for watching.
Thank you.
Keep well.